Now, some people celebrate their 90th birthday with a bit of cake, but not Don Lockley. He celebrated his birthday by plunging 12,000 feet from a skydiving plane over Darwin.
Yeah, to tell us more, Don joins us now from Darwin, along with his instructor, Ashley Smith. Good morning, fellas. How are you doing? Don, you first. What made you decide to go skydiving? Good morning, fellas.
How are you?
How are you doing? Don, what made you decide to go skydiving?
Oh, well, it's been on my bucket list for quite some time, and seeing I got to the lucky to get to the age of 90, I thought, well, the time's running out, so nothing better than to do it right now.
Good on you.
Geez, Don, what was it like standing on the edge of that plane, a perfectly good plane, and launching yourself out towards the ground?
Well, it might seem strange, but, you know, I'm an outdoor person and I've done lots of things, and I've climbed the Three Sisters at Katoomba in New South Wales, and I thought, well, what better thing to do than to do a sky jump?
Oh, can you describe the feeling for us? I've never been skydiving. Have you been skydiving?
No.
No? What's it like actually throwing yourself out of a plane?
Well, it's just, slightly apprehensive when you're out on the wheel, but once you leave the aircraft, it's absolutely fantastic.
The pictures are amazing. Have you ever considered doing this before, Don? I mean, was this something that you've turned down in the past and now decided you're ready for?
Sorry, what was that?
I said, is a skydive something that you've ever considered before in your life and turned down?
What I've been thinking about, as I said, it's been on my bucket list and just hadn't got round to it, but maybe hadn't plucked up the courage to make the decision.
Well, look at you now. Not a bother on you jumping out there. You live a very active life. I mean, you're still running around in the heat of a Darwin hockey pitch at 85. What's the secret?
I think I've looked after myself. I've never smoked. I keep a positive attitude to life, and I try not to worry about things that I've got no control over.
That's awesome.
It's all really good life advice there. Ashley, can you talk us through the jump? Were there any challenges that you two faced heading out?
No, not really. It was nice and peaceful in the aircraft, just looking at the scenery and chatting, and a bit of a surprise when the doors opened, the noise and the roar from the cold wind. And that, as I said, the initial leaving the aircraft, that's a little bit of a, not a worry, but yeah. then once you get the free falling, it was absolutely incredible, and the scenery was marvellous. And then when the, well, I was coming down, I was wondering, yeah, right, well, the scenery's new, but when's the chute going to open? But anyway, once it opened, the gliding part was absolutely incredible. And luckily, a safe landing. All a wonderful experience.
The great thing is you had wonderful Ashley guiding you down back to Earth. Ashley, how did Don do?
He went very, very well. Like, we'd done a couple of practices, and in the plane, he was like, I think as you get older, you become less apprehensive, because, like, we've done a couple of other elderly people, and they're just not really, not saying not a care in the world, but they are just taking their stride. They're not very nervous. We got out. John's very fit, so we managed to get out the plane very easily, very quickly. The landing, he lifted his legs up the landing. It was a perfect landing. And Don was actually like the perfect student.
It was a
great jump overall.
It is great to hear. Yeah, what's that like, Ashley? When you're helping people knock things off their bucket list, do you get a lot of that?
Yes, we do. We do. They say they only ever want to do it once, but generally people come back and do it again because they've had such a good time.
Hey, Don, you're a grandfather.
Yes, I'm a grandfather and a great-grandfather.
Oh, what do your grandkids think about this, a daredevil granddad?
Well, some of them have actually jumped themselves, some of my relations, and but they think it was pretty good of me, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And Don, what's next on your bucket list? Could it be bungee jumping, maybe a piercing, a tattoo?
No, well, bungee jumping's not, because I don't believe that your body is meant to suffer that sort of stress. But
fair enough. No piercings in the future, maybe a tattoo?
Sorry, what is that?
what's next on your bucket list? What other big thing are you going to do next?
Well, I'd like to see if I could control an aircraft, because I love flying.
Ooh.
And when the COVID goes, I'd love to do a round-the-world trip, a cruise. I've been fortunate enough to do around the world by plane and train and a small ship. So I'd like to take an extended holiday around the world on a ship. But when that, if it'll happen, I'm not sure.
I reckon you can do it. Don and Ashley, thanks for joining us. And Don, happy birthday, the big 9-0. Well done.
Thank you very much indeed.
Can't wait to see your next venture. Good on you.